Tina. I'm back with my 34-week pregnancy update. I hope you guys don't mind. I'm in my pajamas. It's been a long day. We've been running around today, so I just thought I'd go ahead and film this. I was too tired to get dressed. Speaking of tired, that has been the theme of this entire week. I have been so exhausted, just really tired, feeling like my energy's just been fully zapped. So anyway, I apologize for my jammies, but I hope you guys don't mind. How far along are you? I'm 34 weeks and one day today. How big is the peanut? According to my apps, she's around 5 pounds, maybe a little bit more, maybe a little bit less. Total weight gain or loss? As of right now, I am 22 pounds up from my pre-pregnancy weight. Maternity clothes? Yes and no. I still am wearing my maternity clothes that I purchased, but not as frequently as I'm wearing things that I've bought since then that are just kind of like a size or two bigger than what I normally wear. I'm finding the maternity clothes, especially the jeans with the panel, to be really, really constricting and uncomfortable at this point. So I'm just trying to wear like more dresses that are like flowy and things that are just nice and loose on me so that I'm not so constricted, because the maternity stuff is cute, but it's also, it just feels really tight, and right now I'm so just over everything being super tight. Anything tight at all is just really bothering me. So loose and flowy is the name of the game here. A lot of sundresses, a lot of things like that. It's really hot here already, so you know, those have definitely been a lot more comfortable than wearing maternity clothes that have like the panel or the shirts that are a little bit tighter. Sleep. So I've mentioned this in the past few weeks as far as updates go. Sleep's horrible. I'm not sleeping well at all. I'm in a lot of pain, which I'll get into in a minute. But it's just, it's getting worse than, you know, what I thought it would get, which is crazy, which is keeping me up at night. I'm also having a little bit, probably pregnancy insomnia. I think a lot of people get that, and it's you know, definitely happening to me. I've just got so much on my mind, so much to prepare for, so much to plan for. I'm excited, I'm nervous, you know, there's things like that. I also do get a lot of contractions at night, Braxton Hicks and things like that, so that also keeps me up. Best moment this week? Well, I guess the best moment this week was probably getting, I'm trying to think, maybe her diaper bag finished. That was pretty good. I was excited to get that done. I'm working on my own hospital bag now, which will be done hopefully tomorrow. But I was really happy to just get her bag done, completely finished, so that if anything were to happen, if I were going to go into labor, that's at least her stuff is done, and that's what's important, so I can grab that and go. Symptoms. So, as I mentioned, I've been in a large amount of pain. I probably, you know, a lot more than I thought I would be in. So basically what's going on is that I've been having some sciatica and hip and pelvis pain, but it's definitely increased a lot this week. I mean, I have a very high pain tolerance. If you ask my husband or anybody, I'm not someone that shies away from pain or that is a complainer or anything like that. But walking around, and anything really, walking is really, really painful right now, and it's because my hips and my back and my pelvis are just shot. Like, I can't walk around. Even just going to the grocery store or to Target or something like that is just, it's a lot for me. I mean, I'm not totally, you know, in bed all the time, but it's very painful after a very short amount of time for me to walk. I'm gonna see my doctor this week, so I'm gonna ask them about it. I don't know if there's anything that they can do about it per se, but like this week I did have to take some Tylenol for the first time in a couple of months, just because of the pain level that I was in. It's probably on a scale of 1 to 10, it's probably like a 7, which is bad, especially for me, again, because my pain tolerance is pretty high. I don't know what's going on. I don't know if it's some sort of, I feel like it's just my bones maybe like spreading out. I don't know. I have no idea. Also a little bit of sciatica, but not so much as before, where it was kind of running down my leg, as it is just straight up, you know, hip pain. My bones and my hip bones are hurting. So anyway, I'm gonna ask my doctor about it. But yeah, that's pretty much my symptoms this week, along with the sleeping thing. So, you know, it's getting closer and closer towards the end of the pregnancy. It's just getting more and more uncomfortable in general. Food cravings. You know, nothing crazy, but yeah, maybe ice cream this week. I've definitely eaten ice cream quite a few times. Definitely been enjoying that as well. Food aversions. Nope, nothing I can really think of. I haven't felt too, I don't know how to explain it. I haven't really felt too hungry this week. I've kind of had to force myself to eat. It's so bad, but I get going in the morning and I'll kind of forget to eat breakfast, which I cannot do. So my body definitely lets me know when I need to eat, and if I skip meals, or if I forget to eat on a timely basis, then I start feeling really bad. So I'm trying to get more into a routine of it, but food in general just hasn't been a very big thing for me at all this week. I've just been kind of not hungry, not really feeling too much like eating, probably just because I'm tired and I'm hurting. Gender, still a girl. Labor signs, no, nothing aside from the Braxton Hicks, nothing crazy. No changes as far as that goes. Belly button in or out, it's still halfway, but it's poking out more and more every day. What I miss being able to walk around and not being in pain. I do miss that a lot. I kind of miss wine. Yeah, I'm looking forward to having a nice glass of wine after she's born. My husband was like, you know, when you have the baby, I think I'm going to get you a nice bottle of wine. And I was like, that would be a really nice gift. Thank you so much. Because you guys know I did love wine. I do love wine. So I was thinking about that a lot this week. I'm like, oh, I can't wait to have a glass of wine. That'll be good. What I'm looking forward to? Well, I'm really just looking forward to, at this point, I have a doctor's appointment this week. I like going to my doctor's appointments because it kind of, you know, get to get an update on where everything's at, how I'm doing. It's really reassuring when I leave there. You know, they tell me everything's okay. So I'm looking forward to the doctor's appointment this week. Milestones. She's like done developing in there. She's ready. I mean, she's not ready. She's not full term in the sense that I still need a few more weeks until she is. But I mean, she's gotten really far in her development. You know, I was reading this week, it sounds kind of gross. I know my husband was a little grossed out by it, but the coating, the waxy coating on her skin, I guess, is falling off now, just preparing her more and more for birth. But I mean, she's fully grown as far as her bones are developed, all of her organs, everything is fully developed. She's just, in the last few weeks now, just going to be putting on weight. I mean, that's really the only major developments that she's going to have. So no big milestones this week or anything like that. Bump. I have a bump. It is a big bump. I'm going to show you my bump. Hang on just one second. Okay, so as you can see, nothing's fitting very well these days, but because my bump has grown a lot, I'll show you guys also. Actually, this is probably a better way to look at it. But here she is from the front, and then from the side, and this is the other side. But yeah, I mean, as you can see, I feel like she's tripled in size. Even since the last update, my bump is so huge right now. I'm massive and heavy, so she's definitely getting big in there. Alright guys, so that is the end of my 34-week pregnancy update. I thank you guys so, so much for watching, and I will see you guys later. Bye!